Hello friends, my name is Doug. Welcome to the Third Style Garage. Today's episode is a how-to if you have a chain-driven hoist or a chain fall or a manual hoist, typically that will lift but won't drop. You may have a problem with an internal clutch. That's something that I faced in a recent restoration of a budget one-ton hoist that I have. They tore apart and restored. That's another video similar to this. I encourage you to watch the full thing if you're interested in seeing that. But a big part of it for me was trying to figure out how in the world does the clutch work? Why won't the clutch release and allow it to lower down an object? And I found very little help online. Couldn't find videos as to how it worked or how to fix it. So through a lot of struggling, I want to share with you what I learned as I finally figured it out. So stay tuned and I'll tell you what I learned. As I mentioned in the intro, mine is a budget one-ton manual chain fall hoist, although I think the mechanism for how this works is very similar to other brands. I know Cyclone is similar, so even if you don't have a budget crane or hoist, this may help you figure out what's wrong. Took me a while to get my head wrapped around how these worked, and I spent a while drawing a diagram. Basically, the way mine worked is there are three different shafts that drive power throughout the hoist. Most of my consternation came with the clutch or the brake on it. So I simply took three wooden discs, and I'm going to try to simulate how these work. Now, imagine a shaft comes through here. This is the wheel that is driven. So there would be another cog or gear driving where my finger is, which would drive this gear forward, which would lift the load. Now, all three of these, imagine all of them as solid. So there's a gear driven on this side, which goes this way, which drives this gear forward, which turns the shaft, which basically goes to another gear this way, which goes back to the gear that drives the chain. So imagine it's kind of an S-shaped path in mine. But what I want you to focus on is these three. Imagine them all being solid together. So this gear is driven forward, which also drives this gear and this gear, all locked together. Now, on the back side of this gear is a powel, P-A-W-L, or a cog, or a tooth, or a lever, or a little arm. So this middle gear has teeth on it. Got my Sharpie. Let's draw some teeth on here. There actually are teeth on both of these gears. So now you can imagine as this gear goes forward, it goes click, 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 but it won't go back. The minute it tries to go back, this powel, P-A-W-L, powel, locks in there and stops it from going backwards. So as you lift this load, say you're lifting an engine, this locks it from going back down or locks it from dropping it, going backwards, things like that. But you do need to lower it sometimes. And we all, most of us know that when you pull the driven chain, the hand chain the other way, it does lower things. So if this powel has locked in on a tooth, how in the world do chain hoists go backwards? That was the question I had to figure out. So the next thing to solve that mystery is I need you to realize that between these two gears right here is a clutch. So imagine that gap is filled with an 1/8 inch kind of a rubberish brake pad type material. And these are all squished together locking it in place. So that's one important thing to know. There's a clutch material in there. That's where our problem is. That's probably all seized up. The other thing you need to realize is this thraft here is threaded. So in the video clip I'm going to show you in a minute, you'll see as I thread this wheel out, you'll see how it's threaded. So if I want to lower the engine that I've lifted with my hoist, instead of turning the gear this way, which will raise my load, I'm going to try to turn it this way. But the middle cog gear won't go because the Powell has locked it in place. This gear, however, will turn. As it turns, it's on this threaded shaft. And as it turns, it walks away from this gear, takes the side load off of this gear. This gear now, like releasing your, taking your foot off of the brake, takes the pressure off of the clutch. Now remember, this middle one is locked in place by that Powell. Now both of these are able to turn and it lowers your load down. But the load hanging on this, because of this gear, will always drive it back. So your load only lowers far enough for the pressure to be placed onto the clutch again until you lower the chain further, which takes the pressure off, which allows both of them to turn. Sorry, they're kind of both turning like that. So you have to realize that it's a kind of a multiple step process. So the weight of the engine that you're lifting drives your outer gear into the clutch and the brake and locks it in place. As you back your chain fall off, that releases that pressure, which allows the clutch to slip, which allows your load to lower, but only to the point at which you've moved the chain. So it's this constant, infinitely variable clutch pressure load balancing it all in action, which is pretty stinking awesome. It's genius. So if you're lifting a 1-ton block of steel, that clutch has tons of grab to it and that brake has tons of force on it and it holds like crazy. Or if you're just lowering the weight of the chain, it releases itself so the weight of the chain will pull it down. Took me a long time to figure that out. Now watch the video and you can see in action how the outer gear, I didn't know what to call it, so I called it the main clutch gear number one, and then the inner clutch gear number two, how those spin independently of her. And if you look deeper inside the chain fall past gear one, gear two, you'll see the clutch pad and how that spins separately from the clutch. So those are your three wheels. I hope this is helpful to you. Watch the actual footage and that may add to my explanation and make it more understandable. It is a really big thread. Look at that. And that is a clutch material right there. And a bronze bushing, and that's a clutch. All right, so I have the chain fall mostly back together. The chain wheel drive is on. I don't have the guard on yet. That just sits over there. The chain would go through here. Before I put it back together the rest of the way, I want to show you how it operates. It took me too long, embarrassing a long amount of time to figure this out. So in here is, I don't know what the names of these are, so I'm going to call it the main clutch gear and the secondary clutch gear. The secondary clutch gear has a metal cog or lever or Powell that engages to stop. If you notice that movement right there, it swings up, and then this way it swings back down. and it stops that secondary gear. So when going this way, the secondary gear bounces past it. But then when going backwards, it swings down and locks it so it slips. Forward, it slips past. Backwards, it locks. Slips, locks. Slips, locks. When it locks, the secondary gear slips, and as the primary gear turns, it unwinds on that thread that's back there, thus pulling it out ever so slightly and allowing the clutch to slip. So this way, they both turn. And you can see the drive gear turning in a very reduced fashion. Now I'm going to reverse and go the opposite way. The cog, the powell engages, the clutch slips. Now the drive gear goes the other way. When I had the clutch apart, I simply cleaned it, took the rust off of it, and lubed everything up, put it back together. The clutch material itself was completely adhered on one side of the clutch. I don't know if I was supposed to remove that or not. I left it because it was pretty solidly adhered, and then just resurfaced the other face of it as if you were turning a brake rotor or drum, just to get rid of the rust that was on it. So now I'm gonna assemble this and put the rest of it back together. Just wanted to show you that before it was all hidden again. If you have additional thoughts below, feel free to post a comment. If this is helpful, I'd love it if you'd hit the thumbs up button and click subscribe. And I hope this helps you with your project. Have a great day. Thanks for watching the video, and be nice to one another. Thanks.